Hi, this is Raman, your tutor from Alberta Real Estate School. In today's video, we will take a look at time value of money. This is a topic you'll see in your commercial real estate exam. So let's dive in.
Today, we'll take a look at time value of money. So what is time value of money? This is a concept that we talk about in commercial real estate. So if you're preparing for your commercial real estate exam, this is a very important concept that we need to understand for that exam. So what exactly is time value of money? Time value of money, this is a financial concept that tells us that money in the present is worth more than the same amount of money to be received in the future, which means the dollar in our hand today is worth more than the same dollar that we may receive in the future. So money today basically has more value than the money in the future. So why is this? There are three main reasons for this. So let's take a look at it one at a time. So reason number one, the first one is a dollar that is received in the future means that we cannot use that money today. We cannot buy anything with it. We cannot invest it to earn interest. We cannot do anything with it because we do not have it in our hand today. That is called the opportunity cost. Anytime you delay receiving the money, there will be an opportunity cost associated with it, which means that you cannot take advantage of other opportunities that may come your way because you have invested that money or you do not have that money. So you cannot put it towards another opportunity. So that's the opportunity cost. Another reason the money tomorrow is worth less than the money today is because there's no guarantee, there's no certainty that we will actually receive that money in the future. So there is this uncertainty around receiving the money. We don't know. Something could go wrong and we may not make any money. We may actually lose the money. Because of this reason, the money in our hand today is worth more than the money we receive in the future. This is the same thing as they say, the bird in hand is worth more than two in the bush. Reason number three, the dollar has greater purchasing power today than in the future. We have seen this even in real estate. The property you could buy 10 years ago for $100,000 will be worth way more today than it was worth 10 years ago. So this is because of inflation. Inflation means that every year the cost of goods goes up. So it doesn't matter what it is, whether it's car, property, groceries, everything goes up in value over time. And because of that, the money loses value. And that is called the concept of inflation. And that is the third reason why the dollar that we have in our hand today is worth more. We can buy more with it than what we may receive in 5 years or 10 years. So what is the benefit of the time value of money concept? This is an important concept for investors when they're analyzing opportunities for commercial real estate investment. The time value of money concept allows investors to gauge whether the investment's future earning potential actually justifies the amount of risk that they will be taking today with the money they are spending today. So this is a very important concept to basically figure out what investment an investor should make. Should we take investment A or B or C? And this is how we can look at different opportunities and see how much money we'll be getting in the future and bring that into today's term and see which project will actually make more money. So let's take a look at different variables that we will need when we are working with this concept. The first one is present value. Present value is basically the amount of money that we have today, what it will cost to buy something today. Future value, this is the amount of money we will receive in the future. And we also have N, which is the number of periods over which our investment will be held. And then we have payments. This will be the payments that are made over a period of time. This could be payments that are being made out. So we are spending the money like mortgage payment, or this could be money that we are receiving like net operating income coming in from the investment. And the last one we have is interest rate. In order to figure all this out, we do need to know what type of interest rate we have. So let's take a look at these variables. First, we have present value. This is the initial investment we will make. And then we have N. This is the number of years over which we are holding the investment. This could also be number of months, but according to our questions that we will do, we'll look at N as a number of years. And then we have future value. This is how much we will sell the property for at some point in future after the number of periods we have held it for. And then we have payments. So payments will be the money that is coming in. So let's say we have an investment. So we put money out. So this is our cash outflow. We actually paid money to buy an investment property. And then we have payments. These will be the money coming in. So this is our operating income that is coming in from the property. And finally, we will have the future value. This is where this is the amount of money we will actually sell the investment for. And of course, we have I, which is our interest rate. So let's take a look at an example here. So let's say somebody purchased a building for $15 million. And in the future, they sold it for $20 million. So there is an appreciation in value. So our present value is $15 million. And our future value is $20 million. And in between, we are getting net operating income of $500,000 each year. So we invest $15 million, make $500,000 in net operating income every year, and then we sell the property for $20 million. These are the different variables we will have when we look at this concept. All right, so let's move on to calculating present value. So this is the first variable that we looked at. So let's take a look at how do we go about calculating present value. All right, here's an example. You're an investor interested in buying a fourplex that's on sale for $500,000. You want to know what's the most you should pay for it if you wanted to sell the fourplex in 3 years for $650,000 and expected to earn an annual return of 12%. So let's identify the variables in this first. First thing we have is future value. So our future value here, it says $650,000. So it tells us that we are wanting to sell the fourplex in 3 years for $650,000. So $650,000 is our future value. This is how much we will receive in the future. And then we have N equals 3. So we are going to hold this investment for 3 years. That's why the N is 3. Next one is IYR or interest. So the amount of interest we want here would be 12%. So IYR or interest is 12%. Now we need to find out what the present value is. And here is something you want to be careful about when you're looking at this type of a question. On the exam. So here they say that there's a fourplex that's on sale for $500,000. This is not the present value because we have to look at what the question is asking. How much would you be willing to pay for this? How much should you pay for this? That is the present value we are trying to find out. So don't get confused with this $500,000. This is just what the property is listed for. Just because the property is listed for $500,000 doesn't mean that's the amount of money we should pay for it. So here, when we calculate the present value, we're trying to figure out how much should we pay for it so that we are able to get our 12% return if we sell the property for $650,000 in the future. So in this case, the answer would be $462,657.16. Now, how did we get that amount?
So let's take a look at the steps on the calculator. So the first step we'll do here is clear the calculator. So we'll press the orange key and C. This will clear everything. If on the display you did not see 1PYR, then you would press 1 and the orange key again and the payment button. Under the payment button, you will see the PYR. So we press that. And now if we clear the calculator again, our display will say 1PYR. So this means our periods, compounding periods are set to 1. Next step here is we have to enter the variables in. And for this, we will use the top row of the calculator. So we have 3 years, which means we'll press 3 and then N, which stores it in N. Next, we'll press 12.
IYR, which is our interest rate, and our payment here that we receive at the end, our future value will be $650,000, which we store in future value. All we have to do now is press the PV button. And as we can see here, our answer is $462,657.16.
Thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you would like a recap of today's video in a PDF format, make sure you click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.